Hey there, do you think your clients, the people that are going to hire you, check you out on social media? The answer is yes. They check you out. They look at who they're going to be working with. They want to make sure that you're the right fit for their personality and style of business. And when we realize that, it may affect how we portray ourselves and what we're posting on social media. Some interesting information from Career Builder. Career Builder says that 70% of employers, and that's what our clients are, they're our employer, are checking out and using social media to screen their potential hires. So interesting information. And beyond that, even if they don't do it at the outset, people that are employing you will often come back and circle back and look at your social media at some point. And we often encourage them to do so because we're posting, they're listing on Instagram and Facebook, and we're talking about social media as a marketing tool, which is related to this next statistic, which is 43% of employers use social media to check on their current employees. So at some point, even if they don't do it in that hiring decision process, they're going to do it during your listing or during your escrow period. So what you post can be important. Here's a gentleman, real picture that he posted. And you might say, well, that's kind of crazy, but not too bad. The problem is he sent a message to his employer that he couldn't come to work, and he claimed he had a family emergency. So he then posted this pic on his social media. Before firing him, his boss wrote this: I hope everything's okay. Cool wand. So we don't want to get caught in that trap of putting out something on social media that we wish we hadn't. So here's nine things not to do on social media. Nine things not to do. Number one, look like a bad worker. Don't look like somebody who's lazy. Look like somebody who's getting something done. This is where some agents have a resistance to putting actual real estate information out on their social media feeds. You should be doing the 80-20 rule. 80% of your personal feed should be personal stuff, but 20% should be real estate related, so people see you're working and you're busy, right? Second, don't take the bait of turning off your social media. Some people say, well, I'm just not gonna have any social media. That way I can have no problem. But when people see a black hole in your digital footprint, they wonder what you're hiding. Don't do that. Be somebody that's out there using social media. It's a part of our, you know, everyday life. We all know that. And it's also a big part of real estate marketing today. Third, don't forget to proofread. When you forget to proofread, it's not a good thing. You want to make sure that you are checking and rechecking what you're going to send. Not obsessively, you don't have to be perfect, but definitely take a look at what you're going to send out before you hit the post button. Don't have a split personality. That means don't be something, you know, during client meetings and someone else on your social media. Don't be somebody that looks like you're completely two different people. You should be authentic to who you are, and the clients will appreciate that when they are dealing with you. Five, don't be inconsistent. Make sure you're posting regularly, but make sure your posts are professional. And remember, you are now a public figure. And so you got to kind of think through what you're putting out, what you're posting, right? Maybe if you have any kind of question about it, let somebody else look at it before you put it up online. Six, poor communication. That just means when people like something or engage or make a comment, that you're engaging back. You're just not posting and running. You're actually engaging your audience. Seven, don't be a complainer, don't be a whiner. People hate to see that. And if they're looking at you to decide if they're gonna hire you or not, they certainly don't wanna work with somebody like that. And they also don't like negative people, which is number eight. And last, nine, don't not be yourself. In other words, you wanna be authentic to who you are, be a true representation of the kind of person you are. And that will help you. So, nine things not to do. I hope that helps. Have a great day, good selling. We'll see you next time over at eRealEstateCoach.com.